वेलकम टू बृहन्मुंबई महानगर पालिका स्टेट वाइड एजुकेशन ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन. आई एम साइली नंदगांवकर, योर इंग्लिश टीचर, एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट लेसन. इट इज फ्रॉम द राइटिंग स्किल एंड वी आर स्टार्टेड नाउ. गोइंग टू शेयर द स्क्रीन. Yes, statewide online education. I'm Saili Nangaukar, and today we are going to see the very important topic in writing skill, that is information transfer. Okay, students, now we'll be going to start with some of the warming up activities. Okay, I'm going to show you some of the pictures here, and you have to tell me what type of picture or what you find, what you identify from that picture. Okay, so let's start. Can you see this picture, this image, children?
Yes, Sally.
Ma'am, you have to unmute the children. Students, can you see some images, some diagrams?
Yes,
yes, teacher. It's a graph.
Yeah. Yes, of course. This is a normal graph. As well as there is a pie chart. You have seen pie chart in your maths book, even in the science book, geography book, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. And there is a one type of which type of diagram you can see from bottom? Can you
tell? Tree diagram.
Very good. This is a tree diagram. So you understood all the diagrams. There are some more pictures. I'll just show you. Yeah. Now tell me, what are the pictures?
Web chart.
Exactly. This is actually named out, but it's already, you know, in most of the science book, you see this web diagrams and web charts. Flow chart down in there. Flow chart is also, you understood the flow chart. One by one you can write down the step by step activities. Okay. So I think you better understand all this. So we can start. Exactly what is step. So these all are the examples of your information transfer. Okay. These are the examples of non-verbal to verbal activities and verbal to non-verbal activities. What do you mean by verbal activities? Verbal activities are the paragraphs. Verbal activities are the paragraphs. Non-verbal activities are the diagram. Isn't it? Diagram. Okay. So information transfer is nothing but is an activity in which a given information is converted from verbal to non-verbal and non-verbal to verbal. That means what? The verbal means paragraph. It is paragraph form to non-verbal. That is in the diagram form. Okay. And when it is converted to paragraph. Then you can mute the people.
Okay, then you are the okay.
So
Sally, you unmute yourself. 1 minute, I'm second mute kar de pehle. Sally?
हा मॅम, हॅलो मॅम.
हा तू मग मी सगळ्यांना अनम्यूट म्यूट केले होते, तुला अनम्यूट करायला लागतं ना.
ओके ओके सॉरी. हा ठीक आहे, आय विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दॅट स्लाइड. हा
ओके.
So children, you better understood what do you mean by verbal to non-verbal and non-verbal to verbal, isn't it? Now, this question is very compulsory in your SSC English paper. When you are going to see the paper, you can find out one of the question, question number 6, that is information transfer. It is for 5 marks. Okay, and there are 2 types of question. They have A1 and A2. That is, one type is non-verbal to verbal and verbal to non-verbal. You'll be having a choice whether you want to write one A1 or A2. So both the questions are very easy, and we are going to see how it is to be done. Okay. See, when you start the non-verbal to verbal, writing non-verbal to verbal question, that is A1, there are some type of diagrams or charts have been given in your paper or your English paper. You already seen the English paper. So what are the type of diagrams they have seen? Table chart, pie chart, flow chart, tree diagram, map, wave diagram, chart, or do's and don't. These are the examples where you want to put down, you have to convert these diagrams into a paragraph, that is in verbal form. Okay, non-verbal to verbal. These are the examples of non-verbal to verbal. Now, we'll see next slide. This is the example of A2, question number 6, A2, that is verbal to non-verbal. What do you mean by verbal to non-verbal? I already told you, paragraph to diagram. So you'll basically get some type of paragraph, some type of sentences, and you have to put it into a diagram. That is, whether they have asked for a flow chart, whether they have asked for a tree diagram or any of the tabular form. Okay, whatever question they have given, you have to convert this paragraph into a that type of question, that type of form, that diagram. Okay, so these both the questions have been clear. Okay, whatever you prefer, you can attend any of one of the question and you can score your 5 marks. You can easily score your 5 marks out of 5, and it's very compulsory and very easy question. See, the marking scheme for non-verbal to verbal. Now, you are going to see, you are going to attain non-verbal to verbal. That means your chart or some type of tree diagram into a paragraph. So what things you have to keep in your mind? What are the type, what are the mark system for this? You have to put down a title. So you'll be getting a 1 mark. Then use proper layout. Means whatever there as a system has been given, you have to use that properly. You'll be getting 1 mark. Then covering all the points. You should cover all the points. You need to cover all the points. And you'll be getting 2 marks. Appropriate vocabulary. You should have a proper grammar, proper vocabulary for each and every point, so that you'll be getting 1 mark. And all together, it will come as a 5 marks. Okay. So this is for the non-verbal to verbal. Now, non-verbal to verbal, that is from tabular or pie chart to a paragraph. I already spoken for this. Now, how to transfer information? You'll be having a question, how to transfer this information now? See, state information in complete sentence using discourse marker. State information in complete sentence. So whatever the tabular form or any of the point has been given in your chart or any of the tree diagram or flow chart, you have to mention the complete sentence for that point. You have to write down complete sentence, and one by one sentence you'll be having your paragraph. Okay, follow proper sequence. You have to follow proper sequence. You should go properly one by one, step by step. Whatever is first you have to write, second you have to write. So don't jumble directly to the last or in between. Okay, so you have to always follow this proper sequence. Then you have to cover entire diagram. It's already given. I already told you, you have to cover all the points. You need to cover all the diagram, all the points into a diagram, so that you'll be getting good, all the total marks. No, so this is also important. Explanation should be clear and simple. And whatever you are going to write in your paragraph, it should be clear. It should be simple. It should not be a complicated sentence, so that it will be easily understood. Whatever is given in diagram is converted into a paragraph. It is easily understood and it is easily explained, so that the paragraph is being having a proper sequence and clear explanation. Okay. Now the next. Non-verbal means diagram. I already told you the following diagrams are asked in the category of non-verbal: flow chart, tabular form, tree diagrams, pie chart, fact file also. I already told you this. All diagrams should be neatly and accurately drawn. This is some additional points I am covered. That is, it should be neatly and accurately drawn. Draw all diagrams with a pencil, only label and diagram with a pen. Okay, now there are the some of the examples I'm going to see you. Before that, non-verbal to verbal, I already told you, diagram, chart, table, it converted into a paragraph and passage. All right, now there are some rules. This is already for non-verbal, the same is there in verbal also, but some points it is different. Follow proper sequence, use appropriate language, explanation should be clear and simple, cover entire diagram, write information in complete sentence, and give suitable title. You always have to give the title, because title always contain one mark for that. Okay, you will easily get one mark when you write down a title. All right, now this is the example of flow chart. How to write a flow chart? A flow chart is a graphic representation of how a process works, showing a brief the sequence of steps. Advantages of flow chart: it is a step by step work, because when you do activity, when it is continuously in a step wise, you'll get it very easily. If you are preparing a coffee, it should be a continuous sequence. First you have to take a milk, then sugar, then some other things. So like, this is a continuous process, and that's why it is a flow chart, where you'll be having a graphical representation showing one point wise. What are the advantages of flowchart? It is a convenient method of communication, a key to correct sequence. It clearly explains or indicates the role played to a teach level. That is what we have given. It is a method of communication, convenient method. When you will be not having a time to read all the paragraph, if easily you can understand by flowchart. Some points, if you see some points in on the flowchart, you can easily understand what is the activity is going for. It is which type of activity or what type of matter is given. So flowchart is an easy method to communication, and there are some sequence you have to follow. The sequence, there is a note for flowchart. That is, the flowchart can be drawn in horizontal, vertical direction. It must be a specified boxes. The sequence must be pointed with the help of arrow in the proper direction. See, this is a very important note while you are drawing flow chart. because until and unless you follow these steps, you'll not complete your flowchart. You can draw it horizontal or it maybe a vertical direction, doesn't matter. Whatever way you can write, whatever layout you like, you can put down in that. But you have to put your point in specific boxes, isn't it? You have to put your point on a, in boxes, and that boxes should be continuously attached with a arrow each other. Our first box attached with the second box, then with the next box with the arrow. The sequence must be pointed with the help of arrow in the proper direction, and should be a proper direction. Whatever direction your activity or your process would be, that direction you have to mention the whole horizontal or vertical direction, that flowchart. Okay. Now we can see, this is the next slide. Yeah. Anybody can read for this? The ma'am, you can mute, unmute one of the student or some of the student. Hello. Okay, doesn't matter. I will read for you. Read the following passage and prepare a flow chart. Give a suitable title. Okay, they have given question to prepare a flow chart and give suitable title. Butterflies belong to group Insecta and lay eggs. They pass through four stages in their life cycle. The female butterfly lays the eggs and, sorry. Okay. The female butterfly lays the eggs on the leaves of the plants. These eggs are tiny and have a variety of shapes. After 6-7 days, a womb-like creature known as a baby carpenter out the egg, which is light green or yellow in color. The larva eats leaves and grows fully. This fully grown larva is called caterpillar. It is the young one of the butterfly and does not resemble its parents. Now the caterpillar moves to the pupa. It spins a cocoon around its body and fastens itself to a plant with a silk thread. Finally, the baby butterfly emerges from the pupa and soon is transformed into the adult butterfly. This is the whole process of how butterflies transform into a, one small baby butterfly transform into a adult butterfly. So you have to put down, it is in the boxes and it is in a flow chart. So very simply they have given, I'm going to show you. The female butterfly lays the eggs. First step is what? The female butterfly lays. Then the next step, the egg hatches into a caterpillar. Okay. And the next step, the baby butterfly emerges from the pupa and turns into the adult butterfly. And the last stage is the caterpillar eats leaves and grows and forms a pupa. Okay, so you have to put down it in proper sequence, as well as a proper point should be put down on the boxes. Correctly, it has to be right. And even you have to give the title also, that the title is a life cycle of butterfly. So you have covered all the points, you have put down in all the sequence, as well as you have given title, so you can easily get your all whole mark for this question. Okay, understood children? Now I'm going to give you one more example of this is a tree diagram. We have seen the flow chart. Now we'll be going to see the tree diagram. See, this is some of the type of heading and type of flow chart, like flow chart diagram type of tree diagram. Step to draw a tree diagram. Give an appropriate title. Read the passage and mark all the points in the first layer. First passage, you have to read the passage and then you have to put down the points. Then make the first layer of the tree diagram. Mark the subdivisions of the first layer. use only keywords. Now you have to be very careful. You have to use only keywords, not whole sentence or half sentence or some type of word. Only keywords, you have to find out that. So first important thing is what? You have to write down the title. Then you have to read the passage. First you read the passage, then you understand what the passage is about, and then you can give the title. And may mark all the points, and while reading the passage, you underline the points also. And that point you put down in first layer, because that are the first most points. Then next passage, next para, you write down, again you put down, underline, you again make a next second layer, then third layer, and the last layer. Like this way you can prepare your tree diagram. It should grow like a tree. You can see this. I'll be giving you one example. The tree diagram example. This is verbal to non-verbal. Read the following paragraph and write in a form of tree diagram, putting the correct information. There are different kinds of fuels. Broadly, they can be divided as solid, liquid, and gaseous fluids. You can see these are the three important keywords you found here. Okay, solid, liquid, and gaseous. Solid fuel includes substances, wood, coal, and coke. Again, the next layer you can find out solid. When the solid comes, you have to put down these three, wood, coal, and coke. Underline that. Okay. Most liquid fuels are obtained from petroleum, which is obtained from a oil sunk deep into the earth. Petrol, kerosene, and diesel are all separated from petroleum. The most important gaseous fuels here, natural gas, coal gas, and water gas. Natural gas is a fuel that is widely used for cooking and heating. So all about the different kinds of fuels. So if you understand while reading the paragraph, you can easily find the title also. Now I have given you into a tree diagram. See, yeah, here you'll be having your paragraph converted into a tree diagram. This is a kind of fuels. You have put down the title for this. Then you'll be having a first layer. I already shown you in the first stanza, first paragraph only, and first two lines only. Your first points. First layer of your tree diagram, that is solid, liquid, and gaseous. Then the next layer, whatever is there, sub keywords, or you can see inside that solid, what are the different things you have to put down in that liquid, what are the different things, and the gaseous, there is a natural gas and water gas, and the lastly coal gas. So in that way, it's very easily you can find, if you put down first underline keywords, you can easily draw the tree diagram and write down your keywords, and you can easily prepare your tree diagram. Okay, so it's very easy. Now, yeah. See, up till now we have seen how to convert diagram. Now we'll be going to see verbal to non-verbal, that is from paragraph to diagram form. Okay, so this is the title marking scheme for a verbal to non-verbal. That is, for a title, we'll be having a 1 mark covering all points. We'll be having a 2 marks. Appropriate layout, you'll be having a 1 mark. And overall presentation, you'll be finding 1 mark. So all together, you'll be having a 5 marks for this question. Okay. Yeah, what contains verbal? Okay, the length of the paragraph should be 100 words. It should be at least 100 words, means at least 10 lines. You should write at least 10 lines. Write one or two paragraphs as per instruction in paper. Whatever instruction is given in the paper, write two paragraphs, one paragraph, or you should always write one or two paragraphs, not more than that or not less than that. Cover all points given in a diagram, chart, and graph. So what are the points have been given in your diagram, chart? You have to cover all the points. You have to make it a sentence wise. do not add extra information. You should not add extra information here. Whatever is given in your chart or graph, you have to mention all that information, not different than that or any other extra information. Always use variety in sentence formation. Okay, this is very important. You should not use the ordinary method that simply one sentence has to be written down. You have to have a variety in your sentence formation also, so that your paragraph would be catchable. It will be very much presentable. Okay. Now, we can have one of the example. Or before that, we find what type of question is this. In this type of question, the information is transferred from a passage or a summary into a diagram or a bar diagram, pie chart, table form, or graph. See, this is a passage you have to convert into a diagram, or you have to convert into a bar diagram, pie chart, table form. Format should be suitable. Format should be suitable. Use appropriate signs, for example, boxes, arrows, to indicate exact relationship. You should have an exact relationship. Cover the main idea or concept. Use suitable visual representation. If not the question, you have to use your representation, your own representation you can have. Then you'll be having a pie diagram, tree diagram, and graph also. See, what you have seen in this image, you are having a tabular type of image is this, and you have to put down your paragraph keywords in this. So this type of question also comes in your exam. I've just example. Okay, see, this is the tabular form of question is given. They have given you some information in a table, that is born 3rd March 1847, then occupation scientist, inventor, innovator. Inventor is a inventor of first practical telephone. Then other inventions, photophones, metal detector, hydrophones, acronautics, died on 2nd August 1922, and Bell statues, similar in style to Lincoln Memorial, in the front portia of the Bell Telephone Building of Rundowns, the Telephone City. These are the examples given in a table form. Write given information about Alexander Graham Bell in a paragraph. This is the information about Alexander Graham Bell. So, you have to convert graph into a this table into a paragraph. So very easily, very keywords have been given in this table. How you will be putting it into a paragraph? I already told you, you have to take one point and have to prepare a proper sentence for that. Okay, so how you'll be making this? Alexander Graham Bell was born on 3rd March 1847. See, they have given born 3rd March 1847. So you have framed this type of sentence. Alexander Graham Bell was born on 3rd March 1847. He was an eminent scientist, inventor, and innovator. See, already these words have been given there. You have to put down in the sentence only. So it's very easy. He was an eminent scientist, inventor, and innovator. Okay, the next point, he is the one who is credited with inventing the first practical telephone. See, this point is also going to give this. He is the inventor of the first practical telephone. So you can write down, he is the one of the who credited with inventing the first practical telephone. Little bit, slightly, they have given this sentence and very nicely framed. The other inventions were photophone, metal detector, hydrofoils, aeronautics, etc. These things also given other inventions. You can write down in a sentence what are the other inventions of Graham Bell, and you can frame your sentence very easily. Alexander died on 2nd August 1922. This information is also given, and you have covered this point also. Now, the last bell statue similar in style to the Lincoln Memorial in the front portico of the Bell Telephone Building of Brantford, Ontario, the telephone city. This is the statue that they have given. So we have covered all the points as well as we have framed proper sentence. Okay. So this type of question you can easily attain and your mark also. Next. Yeah. This is a type of graph. This is a type of bar diagram. So in bar diagram, Olympic scores, they have given the medals, which country has, how much medal they have won. So USA, UK, China, Russia, Germany, they have given all the countries, how many medals they have won. And you have to convert it into a paragraph. Now, I already converted for you. Just have to see. Okay. The bar diagram represents the top five countries that won the maximum number of medals at the 2016 Olympics. See, all these things have been given, keywords have been given on your bar diagram. This is a bar diagram. This is a medal. Then there are five countries. Then what the year the Olympics was. There is a 2016 Olympics. So all these points have been clear in your first line. The maximum number of medals were won by the athletes of the US, United States of America, with a total of 46 gola misses. So they have we have seen on a bar diagram how many numbers have been there. I'll just show you again. Okay, there are numbers also given, 46, 37, 38, isn't it? And there, here also you find gold medal for dark line and the silver. Okay, so in that way, you can put down your paragraph, your sentence in a paragraph. Nelson managed to secure 7 silver and 38 bronze medals. The second nation was the United Kingdom with 27 gold medals, 23 silver medals, and 17 bronze medals. So you have to do nothing. Only thing is whatever is given on a bar diagram or any of the chart, you have to put down this information in your paragraph, into your sentences. China was third with 26 gold medals, 18 silver medals, and 26 bronze medals. See, nothing has been done. Only the number and the medal's name have been put down in a sentence. Russia won 19 gold medals, 17 silver medals, 20 bronze medals. The fifth position went to Germany, who received 17 gold medals, 10 silver medals, and 15 bronze medals. And you finally you covered all the points, all the medals name, all the medals numbers, all the countries name. So here you have completed your questions answer. That is a paragraph. You have completed your paragraph. Understood? Is it easy? It's very easy. Okay. I'll show you one another example for this. This is a wave chart. Likewise, bar diagram, you can have a pie chart also. Pie chart, you better know this, because there is a different type. Different things have been put down in a percentage. The following pie chart shows the mode of transport used by children for coming into school. On the basis of given pie chart, write a brief summary. Okay, you have to write down a summary. Summaries are nothing but a paragraph. Okay, so they have been given 8% children are coming by cycling, 17% by walking, 50% is by school bus. So everything is given in a pie chart. So you have to convert this into a paragraph. See how we'll be find this. Yeah. The given pie chart highlights the modes of transport used by coming to school. These are all are the modes of transport, different types of modes of transport. So you have put down in the sentence. So basically they have shown, which point they have shown. It is observed that maximum children, 50% of the children come to school by bus. So that, and likewise bar diagram, you have to put down your number and what did that number, in front of that number, what the thing is given, children coming by school or school bus, you have to put down in a sentence. 21% of the children are picked in and dropped by their parents. So 21% coming with their parents. It is given in a, already given in a pie chart. Whereas 17% come to school by walking. The percentage of children cycling is very less percentage. That is only 8% children prefer the option of cycling and only 4% of children use personal motorized vehicles to come to school. Children, you understood this? All the points, all the separated types of pie charts we have taken, and we covered the whole points and entire paragraph has been put down with the help of your pie chart. It's very easy and you can easily get entire whole score. Can easily. Now, there is one more example I have given for you. The following chart of food chain shows the flow of energy from one state to other. On the basis of given information, write a brief summary. This is a food chain. This is a wave diagram. Just see. Yeah, I think so. Are you better aware of this because you already studied in your science book? After one, there is the thing is depend on each other one by one, and this is a food chain. This type of food chain. So you have to put down it is into a paragraph. How you'll be going to do this? See. Yeah. For an ecosystem to work, there has to be a flow of energy within it. The organism of the ecosystem need energy in the form of food. So first they have shown you food, no? So they have started a paragraph like you have to take energy from the food. The ultimate source of this energy is the sun. Again, the food is getting energy from the sun. Producers like green plants trap solar energy and convert it into the chemical energy of food. When a primary consumer, grasshoppers, eats the produce, a part of this energy is passed on to it. So the energy is going on passing away by each other. The primary consumer is then eaten by a secondary consumer, that is a frog. Okay, the secondary consumer is eaten by a tertiary consumer, that is a snake. You already seen in this year of flow chart. And the tertiary consumer is eaten by the final consumer, hog. The consumer when dies, it gets decomposed. In this way, energy gets transferred from one consumer to the next higher level of consumer. A series of organisms through which food energy flows in an ecosystem is called a food chain. See how easily they have put down their food chain diagram into a paragraph. Okay, without adding any other extra point. All the points have been covered by this food chain. So likewise, you have to do in your exam, you have to go for this diagram and paragraphs. Now, one more example is this. This is your wave diagram. Okay, this is type of wave diagram. The uses of motorcycle saves a lot of time for going out, for buying provisions, useful of for workers, useful for farmers. For students, helps to get the work done speedily. These all are the uses of motorcycle. You use your motorcycle at home. So these are the different types of uses. Now you have to convert it to a paragraph. how easy it is. We have already seen many examples now. See, sources of energy. Just hold on. I think I have given this for a different type. So you just have to put down this, and now we'll turn to the evaluation part. I think better you understood many of the examples we have seen, verbal to non-verbal, and now you have to put down this in your notebook. In between, I think so you have took your screenshot also, no? Now check out this. Question number 6, information transfer. Attempt any one of the following activities, non-verbal to verbal. Observe the following wave chart carefully and write 2 short paragraphs of advantages of watching television with the help of the points given. So this is the advantages, like the same wave diagram is this. I think so, student, you can take this screenshot and write down in your homework book or in your exam English book. Okay, children, take the screenshot for this question. I'm waiting 2 minutes. Okay, so what you have to do for this question, you have to convert this diagram, this wave chart, into a paragraph. And I think so this you'll be going to do by your own. This is your homework. Okay, next question. Yeah, read the extract given below and represent its information in the form of tree diagram and give a suitable title to it. I already taught you how to do tree diagram. You have to find out the keywords from this, and one by one you have to add the layers for tree diagram. So this question also you have to take a screenshot and do it at home. Try it out in your English book. Take screenshot for this. Okay, children, I hope you understood this very important topic, information transfer, non-verbal to verbal and verbal to verbal questions. And you're surely going to attempt this question in your exam, and you can surely get to your whole entire score for this, 5 out of 5. Okay, so here I am winding up my lecture. Thank you so much.